We're on the home stretch, and we will have our t-shirt finished in no time at all. Turn it inside out. Carefully match the underarm seam. If your jersey is thick and this join is bulky, have the seam allowance go in opposite directions. Just pin as much of the seam as you feel is necessary. I have a free arm sewing machine which has many advantages, but for many jobs a flatbed is better, so I often add my slide-on flatbed accessory. So just whiz up the side seams. When you get to the underarm, lift the foot with the needle down and change direction a little. Do the same at the hemline where the sleeve widens a little. Nearly there, get that little curl straightened out and we are done. I have stitched both seams, trimmed and pressed them open. Now all that needs to be done are the hems. First the sleeve hem. We are turning up about an inch. You can see quite clearly here why we need the angle at the sleeve hem. So, as we are going to machine from the right side, we want the pins on the right side. Make sure once again that the underarm seam is flat. For those of you with a flatbed machine, you will need to have your garment inside out so that you can stitch the sleeve hem from the right side, like so. If you have a free arm machine, have your garment right sides out, and you can slip your sleeve over the arm. Firstly, though, I shall check the quality of my stitch again, as these seams are going to be on show. I'm not keen on unpicking, so I like seams to be perfect first time. It is also worthwhile checking your bobbin to see that you have enough thread for the length of the seam. Again, start your stitching where it least shows, at the underarm. I'm going to do about a half inch hem. Keep your eyes glued to the fold, keeping it the same distance from the edge of the foot as you sew. I can feel the ridge of the raw edge of the fabric underneath, so I know that I am stitching through two layers of fabric. Continue past the beginning of the stitching to secure. A pretty good result. So the sleeve hems are done. They will need to be trimmed. But first of all, let's get the hem finished. You may want to try the t-shirt on at this stage just to check the length. Again, it is just a question of turning in, pinning from the right side, and machining a nice straight line. I'm turning up about 1¼ inches. Stitch as before. That's all the sewing done. I have left a nice, generous amount to trim. So that's our t-shirt finished. All we have to do is trim the hem and sleeves, and it's done. Take a look at the inside of all your bought t-shirts. You will notice how, in most cases, the seam allowance is trimmed after stitching. This is the secret to sewing jersey. Try stitching close to the raw edge on jersey. It's very difficult to get a good finish that way. Turn to the right side and give your finished garment a professional press. I've always considered pressing to be an art in itself. It is creative. It is the difference between a wrinkled old rag and a beautifully ironed handkerchief. I like my t-shirts to look really nice, folded and piled high. Calvin Klein, watch out.